Hello, welcome to SS Unitech Social Design, and this is continuation of Azure tutorial. So today we are going to see about the Azure SQL and Azure SQL databases. So what is Azure SQL? So Azure SQL is a family of managed, secure and intelligent products and that use the SQL Server database engine in the Azure cloud. So this is a product which is managed, secure and intelligent, and it is using SQL Server database. So this is the Azure SQL. And Azure SQL is having three types or three flavors, you can say. The first flavor, which is Azure SQL database. Second is the Azure SQL managed instance. And the last one, which is SQL Server on Azure VM. So what is Azure SQL database? So Azure SQL database supports modern cloud applications on the intelligent managed database services that includes the serverless compute. The second one, which is Azure SQL managed instance. So this is the modernize your existing SQL Server application at scale with intelligent fully managed instance as a service with almost 100% feature parity with the SQL Server database engine, best for the most migration to the cloud. So this is the most important feature for the managed instance that you can see. The last one, which is SQL Server on Azure VM. So this is lift and shift your SQL Server workloads with ACE and maintenance 100% SQL Server compatibility and operating system level access. So in our upcoming videos, we'll be going to see in the details about these three flavors. So next, what is the advantage of using Azure SQL? So the key advantages you can see listed down here. So the first advantage that we can say, Azure SQL Server is easy to add your solution with no manual maintenance. Just few clicks and Azure SQL Server is up and running in minutes. So we can set up this very easily and it will be running within few minutes. Next, Azure SQL never goes down unless the entire Azure cloud is down. If entire Azure cloud will be down, only then Azure SQL will be down. Next is, Azure SQL is fully managed and always up to date with the latest release and fixes. You don't need to do anything. We are not required to do anything. It is automatically updated with the latest release and fixes. And the last one, which we can say, serverless computation and hyperscale storage option is automatically scale resources on demand. So you can focus on building new applications without worrying about storage size or resource management. So this is the most important feature inside the Azure SQL. Because once Azure SQL was not introduced, then we had to purchase a physical machine, and on that machine prior we have to set up each and everything, what will be the storage and what will be the RAM of that server. So everything that we have to specified at the starting, so that was very risky. But after introduction of the Azure SQL, we are not need to worry anything. It will be going to increase automatically as per your requirement. So this is the advantage of Azure SQL. Next is, what is Azure SQL database? So Azure SQL database is fully managed platform as a service, that we can say PaaS, database engine that handle most of the database management functions such as upgrading, patching and backups and monitoring as well. So without user involvement. So by default, we can get these features like updating, patching, backup and monitoring, and we are not required to do anything for these. Next is, the Azure SQL database is always running on the latest stable version of the SQL Server database engine and patches OS with the 99.99% availability. So next is the PaaS, so which is the database engine. So it has the capability that are built into the Azure SQL database enable you to focus on the domain specific database administration and optimization activities and the critical for your business. Next, you can create a high availability and high performance data storage layer for the applications and solution in the Azure. So this solution is available in the Azure. Next is the SQL Server database can be right choice for the variety of the modern cloud applications because it enable you to process both relations and non-relation structures data such as graph, JSON, SQL and XML. So next, what are the deployment models available inside the Azure SQL? So that we can see we have two deployment models available. First is the single database and second is the elastic pool. So what is the single database? So single database represent a fully managed isolated database. So what it mean? So for example, if you have a modern cloud application and microservices that need a single reliable data source. So on that case, we are required to use the single database deployment model. Next is the elastic pool. So elastic pool is a collection of the single databases with the shared set of the resources. So here we are not having the shared set of the resources, but in case of the elastic pool, we will be going to have the shared set of the resources. So for example, we can say we have the CPU or the memory and single database can be moved into and out of an elastic pool. So this is the deployment models available inside the Azure. So next is the purchasing model. So this is also very important while we are going to set up your SQL Server. Then we also need to look about the purchasing models. So we are having three purchasing models available. First is the vCore based purchasing model. Second is the DTU based purchasing model. And third is the serverless model. So in case of the vCore based purchasing model, so let you choose the number of the vCore, the amount of the memory and the amount and the speed of the storage. So that you have to choose at the prior. And the vCore based purchasing model also allow you to use Azure hybrid benefits for the SQL Server to gain the cost saving. So this is you have to decide at the starting while you are going to set up the SQL database. Next is the DTU based purchasing model. So it offers the blend of compute, memory and IO resources in three service tiers to support the light to heavy database workloads. So this is very important while we are going to deal from light to heavy database. On that case, we have to choose this purchasing model. Next is the compute size within the each tier provide the different mix of these resources to which we can add additional storage for the resources so that we can add. Next is the serverless. So in case of the serverless model, it automatically scale compute based on workload demand and bills for the amount and compute user per second. So this is as per your demand. If your workload is going to increase, then it is going to charge as per the workload used in the seconds. Next is the serverless compute tiers also automatically pauses database during the inactive period when only storage is built and automatically resume database when activity returns. So what about all these we'll be going to see in the next slides. So here we can understand about the elastic pool. So you can understand very easily. You can see the first diagram. So in this diagram, you can see we are having only a single database. And here we have set the DTU utilization, which is the maximum as 100. As we have only single database, so sometimes it is going to use, sometimes it is not going to use. As you can see, sometimes it is going to reach as 90, but sometimes it is having only 50. And here, in this period, it is not going to use. So we are totally wasting the DTU utilization here because we are not going to use that. Let's move to Next image. So in this image we can see the four databases. So now we have the DB1, DB2, DB3 and DB4. Total four databases we are having, and inside a single DTU utilization, the second option that we have seen. So here we have created the shared databases for this DTU utilization. So everything is going to use here. As we can see, the maximum is going to reach up to 90 only, that you can see for these four times, and rest we are going to use within the limit. Now we can see if we are going to consider for 20 databases, and on the 20 databases we can see the utilization which is going to reach little bit more than 100, that you can see in this case. So if we are going to use the more databases in a single DTU utilization, so on that case we can simply increase the limit little bit, that you can see it is 120 instead of 100. So in this case we can handle 20 databases. So here we are going to use the resources which is very high, as you can see in this image. So this is for the elastic pool. Instead of going to use a single database, we can use the multiple databases there. Go to the next slide. Here we can understand about the serverless process. So inside the serverless process we can see the number of vCores. The number of vCores which is maximum is 4, and we are not going to reach any time with this 4. And in this image we can also see in this period of time we are not going to use, and this is the inactive. So in case of the serverless, if any time duration we are not going to use, then it is paused. So the charges will not be applicable in this period of time, and once we are going to start using that, the charges will be going to start from that time. For example, from here to here it is going to charge, and from here to here it is going to charge. In between it is not going to charge. So I hope guys you have understand about the Azure SQL and Azure SQL database basic concept. In the next video we will be going to create the Azure SQL and Azure SQL database in the practical. So thank you so much for watching this video. If you really like this video, please subscribe our channel to get many more videos. Don't forget to press the bell icon to get the notification of our newly uploaded videos. See you in the next video.